Carol service in 2020 from St Mark's Church in Reigate. We come to open our hearts and minds to the mystery of God, born as a child in Bethlehem. Through our readings, prayers, and carols, we will trace the loving purposes of God, who comes in humility, laying aside all majesty and power. We will hear of Jesus, who shows us the human face of God, who emptied himself for us, taking the form of a servant. We will listen to the Holy Spirit, who invites us to see the presence of God in every human face and in the whole of creation. Let us pray. God, you stoop to reach for us. You give everything for us, longing for our peace, our fulfillment, our joy. You give your very self. Plumbing the depth of human darkness, bringing your light, you come in person as a child in a manger. Word made flesh, God with us, incarnate love. We open our lives, our hearts, our minds. Show us how to see and love you in Jesus and in every human face. Amen. The first section of this service is called Image of the Invisible God. It is beyond our imagining to picture the Creator of the immensity of the cosmos. How can our finite minds picture the infinite? But the child at the heart of the Christmas story shows us the love of God on a human scale.
A reading from Colossians chapter 1, verses 15 to 20. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him all things in heaven and on earth were created, things visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers. All things have been created through him and for him. He himself is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have first place in everything. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, by making peace through the blood of his cross. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Child of the manger, image of the invisible God, fullness of all that is love, touch us now with your deep peace, that we may be reconciled with you and with one another, both on earth and in heaven, as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
The shepherds, the worship. Delighting in the human race. How do we picture God? Distant, angry, judging. There's lots of that in the Old Testament. There are many other images too, that we may be less familiar with. There are pictures of God as a nursing mother, or as an eagle, caring for her chicks. In this reading, the picture is of a feminine wisdom collaborating with God in a process of creation, delighting in the human race.
A reading from Proverbs, chapter 8, verses 22 to 31. The Lord created me at the beginning of his work, the first of his acts of long ago. Ages ago, I was set up at the first, before the beginning of the earth. When there were no depths, I was brought forth, when there were no springs abounding with water. Before the mountains had been shaped, before the hills, I was brought forth, when he had not yet made earth and fields, or the world's first bits of soil. When he established the heavens, I was there. When he drew a circle on the face of the deep, when he made firm the skies above, when he established the fountains of the deep, when he assigned to the sea its limit, so that the waters might not transgress his command, when he marked out the foundations of the earth, then I was beside him, like a master worker. And I was daily his delight, rejoicing before him always, rejoicing in his inhabited world, and delighting in the human race. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Child of the manger, firstborn of all creation, rejoicing in our diversity, delighting in our humanity, longing for our love. Touch us now with your joy, with fullness of life, as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
Little town of Bethlehem, how still.
Child has been born for us. God calls us to fullness of life, abundant life. But we continue to make choices that mean that we walk in darkness, sorrow, and pain. We live in a world of deep darkness, but all can sometimes seem hopeless. But a child has been born for us, to be a light, to bring peace, to bring healing.
A reading from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them the light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Child of the manger, Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace, born for us in the face of violence and terror, touch us now with your love, your healing power, as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
not for him whom cherubim worship night and day, a breast full of milk and an angel full of hay, enough for him whom angels fall down before, the ox and ass and camel which
emptied himself. We have traditionally pictured God as being all-powerful, emptied himself. We have traditionally pictured God as being all-powerful, unmoved and distant. But in the Christmas story, we see God pouring himself into our humanity to reach out to us. Jesus showed us that love is about emptying ourselves of power, giving ourselves utterly.
A reading from Philippians chapter 2, verses 5 to 11. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Child of the manger, vulnerable, needy, helpless. God's love made human, word made flesh. Touch us now with your gentleness, your humility, as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
Let it be with me. God has created us to be free and accords us the dignity of choice, inviting us to cooperate in creation. In reaching out to us, God relies on our response, standing at the door, but waiting for us to send out the invitation. Without Mary's willing acceptance, God can do nothing. So her availability to God is vital to allow Jesus to be born. Mary opens herself to God when she says, "Let it be with me according to your word."
A reading from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 38. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, seeing I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God. Then Mary said, Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Child of the manger, overshadowing of the Most High, impossible hope made possible, Son of God, incarnate love, touch us now with your open invitation. Enable us to respond as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
Oh, how I wish I could sing like an angel. I'd sing carols so high and sweet. Oh, if I had the voice of an angel, I'd be singing that sweet child asleep. Oh, how
mess and muddle. So much could go wrong. Human systems, power struggles, indifference. Life is cheap and birth is dangerous. God risked everything in reaching out to us, in coming as a child into the mess and muddle of our real lives. God invites us to do the same, to risk everything for love.
A reading from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration, and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Child of the manger, born into the mess and muddle of faceless, uncaring bureaucracy, experiencing closing of doors, shutting of minds, making all for love of us, touch us now with your profoundly simple presence as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
Great joy. Religions tend to try to keep God bottled up, defined, controlled. But the Christmas story turns all this on its head, starting with a breaking of the boundaries. This good news is not just for a minority or an elite, not just for people who are religious or who have got life sorted out. It's for everyone, for all people, even the night shift. God announces the coming Saviour to the shepherds.
A reading from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 12. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. Thanks be to God."
Let us pray. Child of the manger, Saviour, Messiah, sign of our freedom, Your birth broke down the barriers, crossed every boundary, included everyone, giving good news for all the people. Touch us now with your good news, opening us to love that crosses boundaries as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
seeing who we really are. The Christmas story is very familiar. It's comforting to hear it again. But what difference does it make? Will we be any different after returning to the Christmas story in this service? Will anything have changed for us? God became one of us in Jesus to show us who we really are as children of God, so that we can begin to recognise God in every human face. I wonder where we need to be surprised by recognising God in others.
A reading from Mother Teresa of Calcutta. God asks us to see Jesus in every human face and to love them as we are loved. I believe in person to person. Every person is Christ for me, and since there is only one Jesus, that person is the one person in the world at that moment. I see Christ in every person I touch. It is as simple as that. Whenever I meet someone in need, it is really Jesus in his most distressing disguise. To be able to love one another, we must pray much, for prayer gives a clean heart, and a clean heart can see God in our neighbour. If now we have no peace, it is because we have forgotten how to see God in one another. If each person saw God in his neighbour, do you think we would need guns and bombs? Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Child of the manger, you are found in the hungry, lonely, lost. We meet you in our friends and neighbours, even in strangers or those we struggle with. Help us to see your image, the Word made flesh, in one another. Touch us now with your compassion as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
Let us pray.
In Jesus, God becomes close to us, bends to reach us, and empties himself to become one of us. God invites us to recognize who we are, who other people are, and to share in the abundance of life and love that this unlocks. A reading from John's Gospel, chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Child of the manger, life shining light into the darkest places, life for every one of us. Empower us to become children of light, children of love, children of God. Touch us now with your true light. Enable us to open ourselves to you as you give yourself completely for us. Amen.
Three kings from Persian lands afar, to Jordan follow the pointing stars, and this the quest of the traveler's dream, where the newborn king of the Jews may be. All royal gifts they bear for the king, gold, incense, myrrh, are their offering. The star shines out with a steadfast ray. The kings to Bethlehem make the ways, and the in worship they bend the knee.
No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is perfected in us. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We say together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Oh,
Let us pray. God our Father, whose word has come among us in the Holy Child of Bethlehem, may the light of faith illumine our hearts and shine in our words and deeds through him who is Christ the Lord. Amen. May the Father, who has loved the Eternal Son from before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children. Amen. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with joy and peace. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, by whose overshadowing Mary became the God-bearer, give you grace to carry the good news of Christ. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and those you love and pray for this day and always. Amen.